Hello students, in important compounds of borane, we have diborane. What is the formula of diborane? B2H6. Now if you see the physical properties, it is a colorless and highly toxic gas with a boiling point 180 Kelvin. Now it is a, here if you see the preparation, it is a, what? It is the simplest boron hydrate prepared by heating what? Boron trifluoride with lithium aluminum hydride. So we have different hydrates of diborane, but in that B2H6 is very easily you can prepare, and it is the simplest form. So here you can see boron trifluoride and reaction with the lithium. It is called as well lithium aluminum hydride, LiAlH4, used as to B2H6 lithium fluoride and aluminum fluoride. Next method is what? Here diborane is prepared in the laboratory. I'm talking about the word laboratory, by the oxidation of sodium borohydride with iodine. Here you can see sodium borohydride with iodine gives rise to what? Diborane, B2H6, sodium iodide and hydrogen. Now come to the in the industry, okay? In industry, it is prepared by the reaction of boron trifluoride with sodium hydroxide. So boron trifluoride, sodium hydride gives rise to diborane and sodium fluoride. So this is for the laboratory, this is for the one industrial method for the preparation of diborane. Here we have the next chemical properties. Here it catches fire spontaneously upon exposure to air, releasing an enormous amount of energy. Simply, if it's exposed to air, what happens? It's going to react with the oxygen, forming the boron oxide, and is going to release the here energy. How much? -1976 kilojoule per mole. Okay, so much of energy going to be liberated. They are readily hydrolyzed in water and gives the boric acid. So diborane, when it dissolves in the water, gives rise to what? Boric acid and hydrogen. So already we discussed in preparation of boric acid. Okay, you can prepare the boric acid with the boron halides and boron hydrides. Here the example for the one boron hydride, nothing but B2H6. React with the water, gives rise to boric acid and hydrogen. Next, with Lewis bases, it undergoes cleavage reaction to give the boron adductor, that is BH3L. Means what here? This is the diborane is electron deficient. Why? Because means that I will discuss later. So here these are the electron donors. Why? Because means we have the lone pair of electrons on them. So they are going to form the adductor. Okay. So it is a Lewis. They are going to act as a Lewis acid. Why? Because means according to Lewis, electron acceptor is what? Lewis acid. So now they are going to take the electron from the what? Ammonia and here carbon monoxide. So acting as a what? Lewis acid and forming the adductor. So these are the adductor. Next, metal hydrides also react with the diborane to form tetrahydridoboride, commonly known as borohydride. All these contain the what? Tetrahydral BH4 ion. Here you can see, okay, sodium hydride and reaction with the diborane gives rise to sodium borohydride and lithium hydride, and diborane gives rise to what? Lithium borohydride. Here you can see this is the cation. Anion is what? BH4 minus. Cation and anion is BH4 minus. Both sodium borohydride and lithium borohydride are used as reducing agent in the organic synthesis. Here, these both, okay, acting as a what? Reducing agent in the organic synthesis. Organic synthesis means what? You are going to prepare some compounds, okay? That is called organic. In organic, you are going to prepare some compound that is called organic synthesis. So reducing agent means what? Undergo oxidation. And treating with ammonia, diborane initially gives the adduct. Okay, this is the formula of adductor. Here you can see diborane reaction with the what? Ammonia giving the adductor. This one here you can write in both are acceptable, like this or like this. So I wrote here like this, which on further heating gives borazine, that is B3N3H6. It is known as what? Inorganic benzene. So this is about inorganic benzene. What is the formula? B3N3H6. So here we are on reaction with the diborane. Here again it is Lewis acid, so giving the electron means Lewis base, forming the adductor. giving the one inorganic benzene. Now here, what is the difference between the organic benzene and inorganic benzene mean? Here we have the structure of organic benzene. Here you can see structure of organic benzene. You can write like this or like this, like this. All are acceptable. Simply, if you see the structure, we have the all carbon atom in the chain, okay, in the cycle form. And after that, we have the hydrogen and alternate pi bonds are there. This is called what? Organic benzene. Now, inorganic benzene means what? Here the formula is B3N3H6. This is formula what? C6H6. Now, here in the ring, we have the alternate boron and nitrogen, okay? So, after that, we have the all hydrogen atoms. You can write here, okay? Inorganic benzene. So, this is not inorganic benzene. Here, we have some chlorine atom. Just strike out. So, this is the what? Inorganic benzene. This is the organic benzene. So, why we are calling as a benzene means, right? It's looking like our benzene structure. That's why it's calling as a what? Inorganic means, already we discussed, inorganic means what? The chemistry which deals with the elements of the periodic table is called inorganic. So it is look like what? Our organic benzene. That's why it's calling as what? Inorganic benzene. Formula is B3N3H6. Here if you see the structure of diborane, it has a 4 terminal hydrogen atom and 2 boron atoms lie in one plane. Here you can see, okay, this is a 1 boron atom, second boron atom, okay. So this is a one hydrogen, second hydrogen, third hydrogen, fourth hydrogen. All these are, whatever I mark with red, all are lies in the one plane. Here you can see. See, this is a boron atom, okay? This is a boron atom and one hydrogen front, and this is a back and front back. So all are lying in the what? One plane. Now two bridged hydrogen atoms are lies above and below the plane. See, this is a hydrogen atom, bridged hydrogen atom. One is above the plane and one is below the plane. Here you can see, this is a hydrogen atom above the plane. This is another hydrogen atom below the plane. 4 terminal BH bonds are regular and 2 centered 2 electron bonds. While the 2 bridged, nothing but BHB bonds are different and can be described as about 3 centered 2 electron bonds. Here in the structure, these are called what? Terminal hydrogen atoms. Okay, we have the 4 terminal hydrogen atoms. And these are called 2 centered 2 electron bonds. Why? Because means this is one center, in this between we have the 2 electrons. So we have the 4 terminal bonds are called as what? 2 centered 2 electrons. So here we have 2 centers, in between 2 bond mean 2 electron. Here we have the 2 centers and it's called as what? 2 centered 2 electron bond, 2 centered 2 electron bond. But in case of here, if you see the bridge, these are, we have the 2 bridged hydrogen atoms are there, okay? So this type of bonds called as a what? Here we are calling as a banana bond. Why banana bond? I will tell here. So these are 3 centered 2 electrons. So if you see, this is a bridge, okay? In the bridge means what? We have the 3 centers, nothing but 3 nucleus are there. But in that, according to our calculation, as you know very well, 1 bond means 2 electrons should be there. But here 2 plus 2 means 4 should be there, but here we have only 3 electrons, sorry, 2 electrons only, okay, 3 centered 2 electrons only. Why? That I will discuss later, okay. So here a bridged bonding is what? Bridged bonding discussing what called as a 3 centered 2 electron bonds. Here if you see the bonding, each boron atom undergo sp3 hybridization. So boron, as you know very well, electronic configuration is what? 2s2 2p1, isn't it, okay? So if you see the one electron, if you undergo excitation, so what happened here? We have the one electron here and here sp3 means what? 1s3p orbital giving the 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals, okay? In 4 sp3 hybrid orbital, this one is empty, isn't it? This is the one is empty. Here this is the empty orbital is there. So here if you see, we have the hybrid orbitals, in that 3 having the electrons. Here for example, take this one, okay? For example, this is a boron having the 4 hybrid orbitals are there, okay? So here what happened is, for example, this having the electron, so this is going to overlap with the hydrogen, and this one having the electron going to overlap with the hydrogen. This one also having the hydrogen, but what happened, it is going to overlap with the hydrogen, okay? So here 3 hybrid orbitals with the one electron over, but one is what? Empty, okay? Now what happened, this empty one, is going to overlap with the another boron atom hybrid orbital which having the electron. So here, for example, this boron atom also having the sp3 hybridization. So this is having the boron with hybrid orbital one electron. So here if you see here, already this electron is shared, okay? Here one electron from the hydrogen, one electron from the boron. So now this is going to overlap. So if here what happened here, we have the three nucleus but two electron only. That's why it's calling as a three centered two electron bonds, okay? So here we have the sp3 hybridization. So of the four sp3 hybrid on each atom, one is without electron, represented by the broken line. Here can we have with broken line indicate means what? Without electron. So we have the four hybrid orbitals, one is without electron. The terminal BH bonds are normal two centered two electron bonds. So already we discussed these are terminal bonds. We have total four terminal bonds are there, that is two centered two electron bonds. But the bridge bonds are called as a three centered two electron bonds. So here bridge one is called as a three centered two electron bonds. Why? Because means here we have the three nucleus are there, but in the electrons we have the only two. Okay. Now three centered two electron bridge bonds also called as a banana bond. Why? Because means here see, you can see the type of bonding how it will look like. Okay, it is like look like our banana shape. So this is called as a what? Also called as a banana bond. Here you can see the hybrid orbitals overlapping. Okay, boron having the four sp3 hybrid orbitals. Okay, so among that what happened? Two is going to form with the going to form bond with the two hydrogen atoms. Okay, so remaining one having the one empty, so one empty orbital will be there. So this is a sp3, this is also sp3, sp3, sp3 hybrid orbitals, these are also sp3 going to form the terminal bonds. So here for example, in what we told here, in 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals, we have the empty. For example, this electron here, one electron is there, here we have one electron, this is one electron, this is one electron, okay. So 3 hybrid orbitals having the electron, this is the empty is there. Next one here if you see, here this is having the one electron, one electron, one electron. For this boron, this is what? Empty. So what happened now? This hydrogen having the one electron, okay? They are going to overlap together. So here you can see, in overlapping what happened here? This is empty and we have the only two electron. But the nucleus is what? We have the three, okay? So that's why it's calling as a three centered two electron bond. Here if you see this one, this portion what happened again? Here for hydrogen we have the one electron. So they are going to overlap together all. So this is empty and we have the only two electrons. So that's why it's calling as a one three centered two electron bonds.